Welcome back to my YouTube channel. So today we are going to be making a dormant sleeve shift dress. Okay, so it's going to be a very simple tutorial, and let's get to it. So these are the measurements you are going to be needing. You're going to be needing your bust measurement, shoulder measurement, hip measurement, gown length, sleeve length, and round sleeve measurement. It's going to be a free gown and with dormant sleeve. Okay, so let's get into it. So guys, to make a dormant shift dress, we will be needing our basic bodice pattern. Okay, so but I'm going to draft that from, I will start afresh to draft that. So I'll be imputing my shoulder measurement. My shoulder measurement is 16, and of course you know when it's divided into two, it's going to be 8. So I'll put, insert my shoulder measurement here, like so. This line here is just as a margin line, okay? You don't have to measure that. So I'll put my chest line. To get your chest line, your accurate chest line, you can divide your bust by 6 and add 1.5 inches to 2 inches allowance, okay? So my chest line is here, and my hip line, I use 24 or 25 depending on the height of the client, okay? So here we are. I'm going to connect them together now. So guys, this is my chest line and my hip line, and I'll also mark down my gown length. So this gown is a very short gown. It's a very short dress. You need it to be very short to be beautiful, okay? But you can use the length of your choice. So I'm going to be using my shoulder to knee minus 2 inches. So my shoulder to knee is 40 inches, minus 2 inches is going to give me 38, but I will leave it at 1040 because plus sewing allowance, okay? So I'll leave it at that 40. So from here to 40, and I will mark it out. So guys, I'm going to bring down my shoulder measurement down here, which is 8. As you can see, this is 8. So I'll bring down my shoulder measurement 8 and join it to a straight line. And that will form my armhole base, okay? So from there, I'm going to insert my bust measurement. My bust is 44 divided by 4 is 11. So this dress, you need a lot of allowances, okay? In this dress, it's a free dress, so I'm just going to be adding like extra 3.5 inches. So I'll be using the half inch to join, and the extra 3 inches is for the allowance up. It's a bit too much. Let me just use 3 inches, okay? Even though it's a very thin dress, but it has to have shape at least, okay? So down to my hip line here. You might be wondering why I didn't put the under bust, the waist, you know. It's a thin dress, so it's just from the bust down to the hip and to the length. So my hip is 50, so 50 divided by 4 is 12.5. so I'll mark down my 12.5 here and add 3 inches, okay? So I'll pick up my allowance from these 3 inches, my sewing allowance from these 3 inches. So I'll measure what I have here. I'll measure out what I have there. This is 15 and a half. So that's 15 and a half. I'll subtract 2 inches from it for my hem. Okay, for the gown length, I'm going to subtract 2 inches from it. I'll be left with 13 and a half. So I'm marking 13.5 at the hemline. So now it's time to connect. So I'll connect from here. So this is the shape of our gown, and let's work with the armhole now, with the shoulder rather. So this is our shoulder measurement, and we'll be using the neck width of 2.5 inches. We'll be using neck width of 2.5 inches, and the down width, and the length is 3 inches for the front and 1 inch for the back. Okay, 3 inches for the front and 1 inch for the back. So I'll connect. Remember, this pattern is for both the front and the back. Okay, so this is it here, but for the front you're going to be opening it up down. So the open up can be up to 4 inches, 3 inches, 2 inches. It depends on what you want, because this dress doesn't have any zip at the back, so it's for easy wearing. Okay, so you can do 3 inches, which is here, or you can do 4 inches, which is here. Anyone you want is okay for you. Okay, so I marked it out here so that you remember when you're cutting or joining, you remember to slit this up. Now to our sleeve. Okay, so the sleeve, you're going to come down the normal sleeve, sloping by 1/2 inch. So this is the normal sleeve slant. You can do 1/2 inch, you can do 1 inch, whichever one you want. Okay, so but for this dress now, because it's a dorman sleeve, because dorman sleeves are dresses that are cut together with the sleeve, the dress and the sleeves are joined with the same pattern. Okay, so I'm going to the length of my sleeve is 13. Okay, so from this shoulder point here, I'm going to measure 13. You know, this is our shoulder. This is the 8 inches for our shoulder. Okay, so I'm going to measure 13, which is here. Okay, and our round sleeve is 12, which when you divide by 2 is going to give you 6. So I'll come down here by 6, but because I want it to be very free, I'll just go ahead and leave it at, let's say, 9. Okay, so now watch me. From this place now, we're going to slope this down to the 13 inches, which is our sleeve length, like so. Okay, so we're going to go down from this place. We're going to go down to that 9 inches that we want our sleeve to be. Okay, so this is it here. You connect it, just find a way to connect it and connect it back to, you know, connect it back to your, just connect it back to your bodies. Okay, this is it. So this is what we have. This is your gown. I told us it's a very, very simple gown. Just find a way to connect this back to the sleeve, okay? And you have your dorman dress, your dorman shoes dress. Now for the pocket, because this dress has a pocket. For the pocket, you're going to mark down from your shoulder line you're going to mark down to 17 inches. So this is 17 inches. You're going to mark down. Then you come down to 8 inches. Okay? To get it. So from here to here is where your pocket is going to stay. From this place is your pocket. So draft out the pocket after I cut this out. So it's very simple. It's a very simple tutorial. This is our gown. As you can see, this is our gown. This is our sleeve. From here, from this 8 inches shoulder mark to this place is our sleeve, which is 13 inches long. And our sleeve, round sleeve, which is 6 inches. But because we want it to be very free, we added some inches to it to make it 9 inches. And we connected the back to the bodice of this lovely dress. Okay, so I'm going to cut it out now on my fabric. But remember, when you're cutting out, you cut out the back neckline first. Let me just cut it out so you can see what I'm doing. Okay guys, okay ladies and gentlemen, this is our pattern. Our pattern is ready, as you can see. This is our doorman dress pattern. Okay, so I'm going to, first of all, because this pattern, I'm going to use it to cut both the front and the back piece. So I'll cut out the back neckline first. Okay, this is it. So after cutting it on my fabric, I'm going to now cut out the front neckline and open up the slit. Okay, so I'll do that now and I'll get back to us. So guys, I finished cutting out my pattern, but I want to do a little adjustment to this pattern. I want to make my neck width 3 inches. You know, I did 2.5 inches before, and I want to make an adjustment to it to 3 inches. So I'll increase it by 1/2 inch. Okay, I'll increase the neck width by 1/2 inches, and I'll connect it back to this. Okay, so this is the only adjustment I'm going to do to this pattern. So I will still repeat this adjustment on my fabrics. Okay, so next is to cut out our pockets. Remember to mark out where your pocket is going to be. So I'll do that now. So guys, for your pocket to be free when you're putting your hand inside the pocket, it needs to be up to 8 inches to 9 inches. Okay, you can do 10 inches if you want, but I'm going to do 8 inches because I marked out 8 inches on the dress. Okay, so this is 8 inches. So there are two ways you can do it. You can use free hand to, you know, draw out something like this and form your pocket, or you can place your hand like so, then you give allowances. Okay, if I'm to trace it, it's still the same thing, just following my hand and go down and something like this. So you cut 4 of this. Okay, just cut out 4 of this. I'll cut it out now, then place it on the on my cut out trays and show you how to fix this type of pocket. So this is the pocket pattern. So you cut 4. So guys, I've gone ahead to cut out a very nice facing for this, just the front alone. I can use bias to hem the back, okay? But you ought to use facing. If you don't want to use lining, you have to use facing because of this slit opening here, okay? So now I'll just pin the pockets by the side and tell us what to do and how to couple these clothes together. It's super easy and super fast. So guys, after you must have hem the sleeve, do with the neck, okay? It's now to couple the two front and the back piece together. So you place this is your pocket. You place it right side facing each other, okay? And so here, remember the notch we gave a notch for the pocket length, okay? So when you sew here right side facing each other, after sewing it, then you flip it like this. You flip it, or you sew with half inch, okay? And when you're sewing the clothes, since you sew the pocket with half inch, you're going to couple the clothes back with 1 inch, okay? So after sewing it straight like this, for the four both side, okay? Remember, the front is two pocket, the back is two pocket. So you flip it out like this, put the back piece together on it, and of course the back should have its own pocket. Put it like so, then you sew just like this and trace out the pocket and down, okay? So I'll go now to couple all this together, and I'll show us what the clothes looks like after sewing, okay? Hi guys, so this is our doorman dress, and you can see the sleeve. Okay, this is the neck. You know, I told us I adjusted the neck by half inch. Okay, so this is it. You can use that 2.5 for a slim person, but for a plus size, please use 3 inches. Okay, so this is it, and this is the front slit. Like I told us, I'm going to use facing for it. Okay, so this is the pocket. As you can see, once you insert your hands into the pocket, it's going to form that shape in front, okay? As you can see it now, they don't overthink it. Maybe there is another method to it. It's the same method, very simple. Just cut it as I taught you and you're going to get it. So give this video a thumbs up if it was helpful. Like, share and subscribe to my channel, and see you guys in my next video for more tutorial. Bye.